Hey guys, hope you're doing great. I know we don't want to get a lot of opportunity to talk like this, but this morning I was sitting here doing a little bit of work and I just thought, we have to talk a little bit about the state of journalism today because I think it's really important. And I think this editorial, this anonymous editorial published in the New York Times is a real inflection point. And I was sitting here thinking about why I am so bothered by it and whether or not we're explaining why it's such a big deal. And I just wanted to take a little moment to talk about that. You know, I became a journalist because the stories that we tell each other that are either really serious or really funny or heartwarming create the reality that we live in. And that's why we have to be responsible. And as a journalist, you don't get a license to practice. You have your integrity and that's it. And I think we're at a time in America right now where we're tackling some really big issues. You know, what does American patriotism look like? What does American courage look like? What does American integrity look like? And we're trying to define these things. And that's why at the core of a lot of these stories, different stories that we're telling, it feels heavy, is because at the core of a lot of these stories, there are really big topics that we're trying to tackle. What does true American leadership look like? What does true American service look like? And so that's why when the New York Times decided to publish this piece from an anonymous source, it stirs up a lot. Because a lot of those questions are being tackled in this editorial and the choice to publish it. And I was thinking to myself, I've been a practicing journalist for, how old am I? 15 years now in different capacities. And if I had to tell a young journalist why this was a big deal, I was thinking this is the way that I would explain it. Anonymous sources are like salt on the table. You want to use them to flavor your food, but they're never the core of the meal. How would you feel if you sat down at a table and you just ate salt? Like, it was disgusting. Ooh, that's not how it should be. I've used anonymous sources before. In fact, I used one just recently out of Nicaragua for SmartHer News, this news platform that I've developed. And I talked to the source for an hour. I could not tell our listeners his identity because in Nicaragua right now, the president is basically murdering dissenters. So I had to protect his identity for security. But I also had to be in charge of reporting the story. I couldn't just put his story out there with no context because if my priority is my view, then I have to think about them. And the best serving for them is a more complete meal. So I can use the anonymous source to flavor the story, but then I have to be responsible with the other things that I'm reporting. And that's what's missing from the New York Times. The New York Times provided a platform, a monologue for this person with no context. And in many ways, the New York Times have done this many times before. We've heard anonymous sources like this over the last several years. They've been a part of all sorts of different stories provided with some other context. Now, I have some issues with that as well, but it's different than giving someone a microphone, pushing them to the center of the stage and saying, talk. And we're really not gonna offer that much for, again, the priority, which is the customer. And that's what I think is missing from this. If news and journalism is about providing a public service, then how does this do that? Some can say, well, this widens the conversation. Look at what's happening in the president. Look at what's going on. We have no idea what's going on. We have no idea who this person is. There's all sorts of questions about that. We also have no idea, do they have a, how high up are they? How high is their security clearance? That makes me nervous now. And then what's next? We're gonna publish this editorial. Then what comes next? Then it creates a whole other issue of, well, is this Pandora's box? And what's the next anonymous editorial going to say? And again, if we're thinking about the consumer and trying to actually provide a public service and inform them about what's happening in America because we're free to do that, then does this editorial do that? I don't know if it does. I think it causes a lot of anxiety and fuels a lot of conspiracy theories that we have no facts behind. And that's not providing a great public service. That's not. You know, I've thought about this for a long time, about news platforms and the need for journalism to change. It's one of the reasons why I made a huge leap the way that I did. Started a news platform called SmartHer News, SmartHer News, that's been really difficult, I've struggled with that a lot, about the decisions that I made to take a leap of faith and do this. And there's a lot that went into that. But when I look at the news platforms that are out there, the traditional news platforms, from major news networks to major newspapers, I have to tell you, I look at them a little bit like the Titanic. You have the people in charge with the most money, wearing fancy clothes, drinking cocktails, separated from the masses, saying that they care about the masses, but they really don't. Dancing, drinking, talking, totally unaware that the ship is sinking. And that's news in America today. That's what's going on. The ship is sinking. This is a sign of that. Like, this is a loss of priority of serving the American public. This is what this is. And that's what I really believe. So that's why I got off the ship and I set sail on a new adventure. And my goal of Smarter News is to provide quick, concise, nonpartisan information. We're a really small team. We put out just a little bit of content, but we have to change. And I'm just gonna leave you with this last part. Just like journalists need to change and evolve and do better, I don't want you to forget the power that you have as a consumer. At the end of the day, the president, and as an elected official, you put him in power. At the end of the day, these big news platforms, whether they're networks or newspapers, are in power because you put them in power, because you read them or watch them, even if you turn them off, because I know some of you have said that in the past. Don't forget that you have a lot of power as a citizen, and you can use that to consume news in all sorts of different ways. I think you should give Smarter News a chance. I think you should give a lot of people that are doing alternative ways of delivering news a chance, because the more you can elevate them, the more competition, and the better I hope that we all can behave. So that's my little monologue for today. I gave myself one. In the meantime, I'm gonna try to go get a cup of coffee and just simmer down. I hope you have a great day, and I'd love to hear your thoughts about journalism and, you know, where we're at as a nation. I appreciate you, and I'll talk to you soon.